Tani ngatso lota chemo gigan namba dang tani loma namba tamchila shuto de la kan samjiji yin.
Good afternoon, good evening to all the students and teachers who have gathered here this evening.
Tani terang ngatso tana mma mangpo tani zom ni ngatso tsama kardashi tani di korkab yakboshong wala ngang pegaboshong song.
I'm really happy to have the chance to engage in conversation with you all here.
Tani derang nga tso tani khabda nang ton khabshang de tani shusok kon phergi ge nang de tani nga tso nang ba ge samlo ge tani shikin phanto gandis tomato de ri.
And the topic of our conversation tonight is going to be about the effect, the influence, and the benefit of Buddhist thought or Buddhist ideology on social development.
Tani terang nge namba tsangma la tani ngotru ziyad kangrezi na tso nga tso bog tani namba sangye pa tani kutsu tani shusong pergye to la tani tartang tawa titone nge namba tso la tani ngotru ziyad.
The focus of the thoughts I'm going to share with you tonight are really the Tibetan Buddhist attitude or approach to social development from a Buddhist point of view.
Tani boba zena tani sacha tani hajang tani muksarwa tani zala tani neoba tani murg tani zri.
When we talk about Tibetan people, we're referring to a people who really are in some ways quite special and unique.
Tani sacha musarwa ti thola yo pi tani murg tela yang tani rune yang tani ga yang musarwa tani ziore.
And because this people lives in a special place, they've also developed a culture that is in many ways quite special.
Tani rune tela korang murg rang rune dang tani chu rune te tani ni yore.
And when we talk about Tibetan culture, Tibetans have their own culture as well as a religious culture.
Tani chu rigne de tarta ji ha chang jap 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 chimbu jang de ni chu de tani lo tong ta chig da sum ja ge gong ne tani jagar ne tani shong bare.
And this pervasive religious culture originated about 1300 years ago in India.
Tani bobala samlo tamba yena tani lo tong cha chig da tani samja tani zga rangla tani mo rigpa samo tani lapa tangmo tani ge tani mo changma de tani korang cho ge tani chu di thola tani jimjig mambo shi ne tani shindu.
And this religious culture was developed in Tibet as a result of, at that time, 1,300 years ago, the most erudite and intelligent members of the population really applying themselves to this religious tradition, researching and investigating it very diligently.
Tani boba ge tani zowo korang tso ge tani samlo tang sa ta jimjik shi sa de kang re zina tani nga tso pamjur ya ge tang yan rao ta tani ge kora tani chong kan ri yam na tani gormu kan ri mangpo sa zowo de ti thola tani jimjik mangpo shi mendug ti thola samlo yang mangpo tang mendug.
What Tibetans over their traditional history were really applying their efforts in research and thinking to were not how to do business or how to improve the economy, how to make money or things like this.
Then he also saw the Koranto Jimjik Shisa, the Gala Jimjik Shisa, the Zenatu Mula Jimjik Shisa.
What they really were concerned about investigating was the human.
Tani mga yin na tani mga lipo ta, mga lipo wana ni chapung zi na si jun zi, tisi kora te jimjik mambu shi mendug zowo te te mare.
But when we talk about investigating the human, it really wasn't research into the physical nature of the human being, bacteria and cells and things like this.
Tani mga tani koso go jimjik shi win ne kum na zowo tani mga tondakni go tola tani jimjik shi ndug.
In respect of their interest in the human, there were two things that they paid most attention to. The first of these was the human life or human life force.
Deni nipa de deni mog sem ge thola deni jimjig man bo she ores.
And the second was the human mind.
Tendi yindi deni khotso go deni lo tong cha chig ta deni samja rang la deni m man bo go deni jimjig man bo she nyam nyu man bo sa deni chorta man bo she deni she bi jimsen ji deni khorang chola che chog dang mi sem ge thola deni tawa yang janda manja wa deni tawa yang man bo ndu.
So it says a result of their efforts in researching, investigating, and conducting experiments into the nature of the human mind and the human life as it were, that the Tibetan tradition developed special or unique views or findings on these subjects of inquiry.
Pena korang so tini tsetok tini tawan ra o tini tawa mambu zu de tini zambolong tong ni parche korang so tini bog tini murg te ma to ba jambala me pan ra o tini ge tini to tawa yang mambu yo re.
In terms of the human life or consciousness, there are many ideas or views that are held by the tradition, the Tibetan tradition, which are probably not found anywhere else in the world.
Then he dang nyamdu tini korangsola, then in jikin gatawa, then he mutse gatawa, rintang gatawa, ditawa sambo de la yang, then he tawa chabrava, zena janda mandrava, then he mambundus.
So, for this reason, the Tibetan attitudes to the mundane world, to the value of human life, and other areas of human value were also shaped and influenced by the Tibetan interest in the human life and the mind.
Then it tawa to so the tawa tito ni shaba yena tini yargizewa, not so yargi, shisoko yargizewa tela, koso tini tatsirka wandushina, yargizewa tela, yargi mundawa sumdus.
So in respect of the Tibetan traditional Tibetan attitude towards progress or development, there were three key ways or areas in which progress was conceived of.
Deni nga chon jambalang ge shirtang ge deni shisok ta wa ji de lan jambalang ge nu shok yin na shar shok yin na shisok yar gi la deni yar gi mambu mambu ndug ta yin na te
So these days, nowadays, whether it's the West or in the East, in Asia, most people, when they speak of development or progress, and this is spoken of a lot, really what people are chiefly referring to is economic development. If we ask ourselves whether social development is characterized by the continual improvement of our living standards, then we cannot say that this is not one form of progress or development, but to let this characterize the entire way that we define progress is indeed mistaken.
Then, book reading the Nitin Tava Tiwan to Shijana, Yargi Laksam Yopinani, Yargi Tambo de Karezina, Mog Simkum Yargi Teres.
From a Tibetan traditional point of view, the first kind of progress that we can speak of is progress of the mind or progress of one's ideas and attitudes.
Tani ngatsu tarstan rabo yina ngatsu nafshuk la tini semkun rikpa yore, shafshuk la semkun rikpa yore, shirtan ngatsu sem la tini jimjik shepa ta shir mambu ndugus.
In today's world, whether it's in the East or the West, there's a lot of people conducting research into the psychology of the human mind.
Yina ngatsu nzambo langa shafshuk nafshuk ganga yina tini sem la tini jimjik shi ndugi to sem ga shi namba shisir zammak tokpa tini tang nguma sem ga nang nguma ti yakbo zi
Yet, while there's a lot of research conducted into the various functions or manifestations of the human mind, there's not necessarily a great deal of penetrating research done into the fundamental essence of what that mind actually is.
mushchik soso mushchik deni gerkin chowa deni deshket yongda dungmur yongda tsoyang deni da ngatsu simda ga tachushik yores.
When we talk about happiness or pleasure in life or suffering and pain in life, chiefly these things are decided by our minds.
Narangso mushchik deni chowa deshket dangdam bazi yong gona ngatsu simchik bu ndugre dele jamba go marezi deze ga marezi.
In saying this, however, I'm not saying that in order for a person to be happy, all they need to do is resolve issues at the level of their mind and they don't need anything else. That's not what's being said. In order for us to be happy, or happiness indeed, relates to a lot of needs, but among these needs, chief among them, is the needs of our mind. So in respect of the direction that society takes, social direction, whether or not this is a healthy direction or an unhealthy direction, this really rests on the minds of the and the attitudes of the influential people in a given society. Over the course of human history, and including recent human history, the wars and great conflicts that we've seen are the result of those with power and privilege not having a proper direction in terms of their minds. So whether we're talking about the very great, large kind of macro level of the world at large, and whether or not we will obtain world peace, or the micro level of the individual human life, then the issue of mind is extremely important.
Tene ngatsu mashi pa de gare jena tarung ngatsu de mayim bitini sem korang ga nang la de korang ga tang la tene ngatsu chama ga mashi bitini sangwa hajang mambon dus.
The reason, however, that people have not known really about the nature of the human mind is that in many ways what lies at its innermost core seems like a great secret to us.
A
great deal of the research that humans have engaged in up until this point has been research oriented outside of ourselves, oriented to the external world or to subjects outside ourselves. Very little has focused introspectively or inwardly on our minds.
Then I don't so tsarig ba in na deni jimjig mambo mambo shi or de jimjig to par shiro to korne deni jitin ga tola jimjig mambo shi ngubo la jimjig mambo shi tindi shi ne deni jimri hajang jachin bo to yare re de sim ga tola jimjig shi ne jimri ta ta ti bar ka ke to mandus.
It can't be denied that a great deal of scientific research dedicated to researching the external world and physical phenomena, matter, etc., has indeed obtained great results. However, the amount of research effort that has been directed to understanding our minds has been considerably less. A Over the past 20 years or so, scientists have started to do research into the mind by looking at things like the functioning of the brain, looking at nerves and how they respond, etc.
Ngama la tuna tini, ngama lo nyishi ngu la tuna tini, titola yadye mambo tini shong dos.
So from the point of view of where we were, say, 20 years ago, where we are now, yes, we've seen some kind of progress.
Yinayang tini koranzo wo tini jimjik shi tanga tini namba moshi, moshi zina. Jimjik shi tanga tini namba tini nangang duze. Tini nangang yopi jimtsinji tartaga warta sim gaksangwa ngomati tarong hako yo maris.
However, the mode by which this research is being carried out entails a certain degree of risk. And the reason for this risk is that still the internal nature of the mind or the secrets of the mind are still not properly understood. So it's really important that the secrets of the mind or the secret of the mind be understood, be known. And it's really only after we can understand this that we will be able to speak about progress and development in any real sense.
Then so so lo jong mambo mambo shi ni nga zo ta nga yan chu ma shi ba mambo shi den di shi ni ma la pa mambo lab na nga zo sim yar ji se ro re yi na ta rong yang yar ji ro jin du se.
So just as we through formal education move on from elementary school to middle school to high school, etc., and with each stage increase our understanding and learn things that we previously didn't, we need to continue in this direction and continue to progress in our understanding.
Then nga chu mo ji ki de gang la ze yo re jin na mo ji ki de gang ji re jin na then ni khorang ge she kha de ni nga chu sim re she kha de ni ngu bo re then ni ngu bo da sim ni nyam de ni de na nyam de zon ba ti de la mo ji ge yo re.
If we're going to understand what it means, what it means to be human, then we need to see humans as being comprised of half mind and half matter or form.
Tani nga cho muti tani shekha ta ngupo yin, shekha ta tani sim yin chardi, tani nga cho ngupo dila tani khoranga tani, ngupo go tani khoranga tani gungkho kong ya manzu ta da shuichu. Tani ngupo de khoranga la tani gungkho kong go gore, yang sim la yang khorang khoranga tani yang gungkho yore, te khorang Congore, the Gunko, the Congo, Remato, Te, Cong Matana, Pena, Nato, Upo, Zupo, Penato, Murta, Navata, Tene, Pena, Lipo, Tene, Gupata, Yantapacon, Matana, Nasola, Lipola, Dumurionare, Tene, same Gupo, Gunko, the Cong Matana, same Gutola, Dumurionadus.
So, given the fact that we are made up half of, you know, material form and half of mind, we have needs in respect to both of these aspects of ourselves. So just as not being able to fulfill the needs of our physical being, like the need to breathe, for example, has great harm on our body, so too not fulfilling the basic needs of our mind has great harm and danger for our being.
Then he poa trina zamazar gore, carcumna chintong gore, then he tangna, kerna, then he comba, gongore, tesotamjibunga so mupo, then he muranga, mupo, then he gumho the partene gongitres.
So the fulfillment of physical needs are obvious things like needing to eat when we're hungry, drink when we're thirsty, wear clothes when we feel cold.
And
after these physical and material needs are satisfied, the aforementioned needs and things like needing to have a place to dwell, a form of transport, etc., once these are satisfied, then we need to begin to think about the needs of our minds.
Tani karti ti kapsa nga tso ngupo utini lipo na nga tso ngupo utini te ndopa to kanji te te ma tokpa, tani sem gu ndopa kanji te nga tso par kirja na, tani nga tso mula tini sem gu tokni ya, pe na zaji me pata kongji me na lipo gu tokla dungur yungwa vishindu, sem korang la yang tini korang ga zamazi yorezi. Te me na tini sem gu tokni dungur mambo yungu dosi.
So just as if we didn't attend to one of our basic physical needs, like needing to eat or drink, then not attending to the needs of our mind results in our mind being in a state akin to hunger or a state akin to thirst, a state of great suffering.
Then it is something that's what you need to go to, sim go to the lion, bena jimjik shikita, sim go to la sorta shikita, sim yargis tongita, halibagar chimboris.
So for this reason, it's very important to do research into the mind, to do experiments into the nature of the mind in order to obtain a better understanding. So whether it's in Western countries or in Asia, probably most university students think that what they need to be thinking about and paying attention to is studying culture, studying knowledge, how to make money, how to get a job, and perhaps relatively few would be thinking about the needs of their mind.
Tani karting atun zambalanga lota chimo hajanga tani shusotola shikin yosan zambalanga tola shikin yosan lota chimundu soga tani ngupo chipo mato bangatso moga tani ngupo chashi tani the din dopa dripki tata mato pa sim gun dopa dripki tila samlo matang sim yargi satungala samlo matang na tani ngaranso maumbanda halipa kangar mambodam chasaris.
However, if our universities, and particularly our influential universities, are really committing their energies only to the research or advancement of the material world, then the direction of our social development will be greatly compromised. So when we talk about the improvement of the mind or the development of the mind, the training of the mind, a lot of people might think dismissively that this is, you know, religious talk.
Then in our answer, most dance in the pena koran chulula tapa yunkin yunanda, menkin yunanda, yana sanji chula tapa shinkin, yeshi chula tapa shinkin yunanda, most dance in that in our kashi.
However, regardless of what a person's religious faith may be, or even indeed whether a person has a religious faith or not, everyone can't but accept that humans are comprised by material, the material on the one hand and the mind on the other.
Tendri yindi tini nga tso tini taga sim tila tini yondar shi gore, pena nga tso lipo la tini yondar ma shi na nga tso lipo nda tini, kare kare nat ramada mambo yong gore, nga tso mambo go yondar yang shi kaya ores. Pe tevjinda tini nga tso sim la yang tini yondar shi gore, ma to sim la yondar ma shi na, tini sim go tola nat mambo yong gore.
So just as we need to exercise and train our bodies, lest they become ill and attacked by disease, so too we need to train and exercise our minds so they don't develop illnesses.
Tani nga tso tarta nga tso tini sim go thola tini zambolong go thola chanchi po kana yena re tini Europe American da so sama yang randa re sim go thola na to haliba mambo yong go ndu ti na ne pe na chap chi shu shi de ga re zena tini nga tso tongsir gna yi yu zhe tongsir gna te je ze pe na tin da wa zo zamba yang mambo ndu zi.
So particularly in Europe and America, but all over the world, mental illness is increasing everywhere. And among these illnesses, one of the most severe is depression.
Tini tongser ke nad de tini yong go wi jim sen te chi ri gan re zena chi de nga tso tini le ga ge sha wa ge nun shi ha jang chi chi wi jim sen ji res.
One of the reasons for the increase in depression is due to the stress and pressure that we incur in our everyday lives and jobs.
Tini nga tso sha wa ge nun shi de ji mang bo yong wi jim sen gan re zena tini nga tso tso wa ha jang mi chi ba sheng huo jie zou kuai.
And one of the reason that our working lives generate so much stress and pressure is linked to the extremely fast pace of our lives. And the reason for why we have this pressure, this need to accomplish so much in such a short period of time, is essentially to do with the desires of the human mind. The way our world works at the moment is like one great big water wheel.
Then it in church in both of the in Corlots or Chickers, 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 Matsutinan in Corlots, Chinese, the Cashes and Cor Massam Naya, Corgore, Mancor Naya, Tavshimadu, Zamal on the Tindy Loni, Sama, Leka, Mambo, Lego, Tini, Shava, Mambo, Drugo, Tisut, Tontongonala, Drugo, Leka, Sama, Yogbon Drugo, the Tindy, Sama, Zambalas, the Tindy in those.
Or like all the internal cogs spinning inside a great big machine. That's the way the world is at the moment, and if one cog is spinning, so do the other cogs turn in response. This is the way that our interlinked world seems to be working. And the reason that it is happening like this is because we see this as part of the development and progress of society.
Rete yena nga chu mu chama ga tin do pa moderation den do pa tin cha chim bo tin je den di moderation den do pa chim bo re song ti tin morere ga langkor mambo khamba mambo sa cha chim bo deni thong khong mambo pe shi tang den du shi na deni ga ta ra nga chu sa ko la chi ma tong men du te yena deni mu chama ga tin do pa te tin ya ji tang jang na tin tha ji deni sa ko la chi bo da nga chu mu chama ga do pa khang jo wa tin ji yong thup ko men du.
However, the result of all of these spinning cogs, the ever-increasing size of our desires, the need to constantly acquire things, whether that be a bigger house or cars or a greater material standard of living, is that we rapidly exhaust the Earth's resources. We only have one world, and it will not sustain this kind of increasing desire forever. If we were just talking about the basic needs of our humans, our basic needs are, then the world in fact does possess the resources to satisfy
these.
However, if we expect the world to, or the earth to be able to provide sufficient resources to satisfy all our every desires, considering that there is absolutely no end to how great and immense our desires may grow, then even if we had 5 worlds or 10 worlds, it still wouldn't be enough.
Then it didn't even be near coming out so that's a summer, then it's summer, as a courier don't you share go, then it's so then it's tabdi and so I care go.
So whilst on the one hand, everybody these days seems to be talking about environmental protection, leading simple or simplified lives, low carbon lifestyles, etc. Without a concomitant reduction in our basic desires, then we will be in no way be able to accomplish this goal of environmental protection. Of the 7 billion people alive on the planet, there is almost no one who doesn't aspire to the standard of material living of the world's most affluent and richest people. However, if all of these people were, in actual fact, to enjoy this standard of living, then we would need perhaps 3 or 5 times our existent world. But of course, this is impossible. We only have one world. So for this reason, it's necessary that we adjust our desires in relation to the amount of resources that are in actual fact available to us.
And
what this entails is essentially bringing our desires into some measure of control. However, in terms of bringing these desires into control, if we attempt to impose or to curtail these desires at a point when we're feeling absolutely infatuated with a particular object, like a fancy car or something, we're really in the height of desire or infatuation or enrapture with a particular object, then trying to curtail our desires at this point is not going to come to much. Really, the only way that we would be able to bring or change that desire, the nature of that desire, would be if all of a sudden there were available to us an even better car, for example, in which case we would shift our desire to that and then cast the former one out of our consideration. So unfortunately, if humans are unable to appreciate anything other than affluent lifestyles, cars, houses, etc., as being signs of progress and development, then it will be impossible for us to bring our desires under control. So, in order to obtain happiness, we're not saying that these things are not part of it or are not to be considered or are not important. However, what we do need to appreciate is that there is a kind of happiness that exists beyond this.
Then
So the sensorial pleasures that things like eating food or traveling or for some people drinking wine bring us are a result of the stimulation that they bring to our senses. What we really need to investigate for ourselves is whether there is, in fact, any other happiness than that which we receive through various kinds of stimulation of our physical or, you know, sensorial selves.
Then you can't think of sim go sawa, me sim go sawa, the shizuna, that's not so la lamka hachang mambunduzi, not so dishit.
If we are to understand, or if we in fact do understand the secret of the mind, then there becomes many potential paths and roads to happiness that will open up for us. For the time being, though, we're not saying that eating, drinking, and the other kinds of material pursuits that we regularly engage in are not necessary. Of course, they are.
Ngasu zama zaje tte ni to zama zaje tte su chere zina ngarang chog tte ni chog ni ge tonda krese. Wei le sheng chun chog ni ge tonda krese. Zama tte ma zana tte ni ngubu long shu tte su mena ngasu chog tte kumari chog I tonda krese.
We, of course, eating, for example, or other kinds of actions that we engage in are fundamental to our survival. But then, after we've used these means to secure our survival, then what do we do? Then to what do we turn our attention? All of these questions that we've been asking are ones that we need to one by one ask ourselves. However, for the majority of people who are in universities, most of students' thoughts are really about their work and their careers and what they're going to do after graduating.
And
the reason that we in fact have to pursue careers or work is because we need to make
money.
And then if we're going to answer the question of why we need money, the answer would be because we need money in order to survive, in order for our livelihoods. But then if we press the question further and ask, well, why do we even need to survive? Why do we need to survive? Then, in fact, many people would come up blank against this. They wouldn't have an answer.
And
if the answer we give to the question of why we need to survive is, well, of course we need to survive. We need to survive in order to survive. If that's what we end up answering, then essentially we're proposing an idea of survival which is without any goal or objective.
And
indeed, if we our survival of our lives are without goals or objectives, then we essentially live in a very empty way.
Then sem ganala sem yarjindro matona tani dungur mambo zyongndus.
So if our minds, if we're empty in our minds, then irrespective of how wonderful our external material world may be, how fancy our car might be, how comfortable our house might be, with an empty mind and an empty heart, then we will live in great suffering.
Tendi yindi nga tso gormu mambo tini sakne, gormu mambo sakne tini zama jimbo zayata, gomba yagpo kyunya tini nga tso tini tsokne muirte mares.
Eating delicious food, piling up a lot of savings, investing highly in our external material lives, these are not the real reasons for our survival or why we need to survive. If we think about it in terms of a car, for example, then adding water and petrol, etc., to it and giving it what it needs is essentially answering the basic survival needs of the car.
Then you lankur ti tini nim mambo chakje ta tini lankur ka ta korang ka shengsun ta mudi korang ka tsogne ka mugyara rezina te rezeji omares.
But nobody would say that the goal of the car's survival is to consume and digest gasoline.
Then you lankur kumir the num chakjeta, num meba shikiti marese, one akarizina koranga lekas lekit, koranga mugir, koranga gubati teres.
Of course, the true function of the car is really what it performs for us, what it does. It's not about the fuel that it consumes.
Then you also mustila sanotana, then you also zamazajeta, kujunjeta, lankur korjeta, kambagana la dejeta, so pena lankurka. Deni korang namta chidang deni korang lokdang jabore de nga chu tesu mena nga chu detab ko mare nga chu ndugsab ko mare lankhori na chime lo me namena korang shawa shi tab ko mare deni jan jan ris.
And we as humans are exactly the same. As a car needs its water and gasoline and whatever not to function, and so too do we need our food and our material surrounds, place to live in, etc. Because without these things, then our basic survival would not be sustained.
Deni langkor yena deni korang deni logdan chidan deni to num to so tamche pon zomne korang deni chogne shi tarvi jini ta korang gon chogne ga nyambo ngomat deni to ta jautong gongju zena deni jimjir ga deni to ta shawa lekka leke teres.
Of course, the real purpose of a car is after it has its functioning needs have been satisfied, its real use is as a means of transport. So as humans, the essence of why we're here and what we need to do is not to consume these basic things that we need for our survival. And what this other thing is, or in fact what this meaning is that is superior or transcendent to our basic needs of survival can be understood as two things.
Then Jan Gaton Dripjita, then you got so the Nita, the Jumbo, Mutubotola, Robashita, Shusola, then you Japchi, and Bota Jigida, then you Mosambala, Robashi, then you Samlo Teres.
So the first of these things, benefiting others, or doing things that are of benefit to others, can be understood as helping other people, people who are in less fortunate situations, people who are poor, people who are in need.
Deni tarta nga tso lobda chimo tso gona la shirk ta lakhsar mambo deni jenga yore ta yinda shirk ta lakhsar zewate one tanishana koran lakhcha zres tsu yi ge gongju lakhcha zam zres.
And the knowledge and skills that we learn in universities today are not ends in themselves, they're mere tools towards other objectives.
Deni ti lakhcha ta nga tso maung bana yapo zu shi ta tsoba zu shi dubo zu shi ta nga tso sem ge takcho go res.
How we use these tools in the future, to what ends we deploy them, is something that we use our minds to determine.
Then in Azo, guarding Azo, then he sim yargis of Tamatavna, then in Azo Lodra Chimbo, Nani, Lojon Shivit, any Jung Azo, then Lojon Shivit, any Rignit and Luster in the Sogo, then he Jima Mambala, Jean Lyon no Payonia, Jean Lyon no Pashipa, then he didn't do a Hago Maris.
So without development in our mind, progress in our mind, then all of the skills and knowledge, these tools that we have cultivated over the course of our education could be used in ways that are of harm not only to ourselves but also to others.
Then you got thing also so tagam in shirk the laxer yabo jang di tolang also samba the yargi yabo tanches tonsumna tantavna then you also laxer dantini shirk the mojan layan pamba yabo toba then you so rang layan pamba yabo toba then is rendores.
But if we are able to really develop our minds, to progress our minds, then using our minds in tandem with the skills of knowledge and technical skills that we've developed, then we'll be able to use them in ways that are of benefit to ourselves and to others as well.
Then you must la tsung yap, then you halibag and zambalanga, then you shoot in the resona. Then you quaranga gormo quaranga ngote, did give a boy on marriage, so by on marriage, then you gormo quaranta, ubozamzere, long shooty, quarant, the bomare, jetty, then you quaranga, then you give mambota, then you long shoot mambo, ubo mambote, then you jean la pamba yon mayon, jean la pamba yon mayonte, then you same catastro gores, quaranga same la raglin dores.
So, for example, a person who spends many years studying in a business school, for example, studying how to do business, etc., and then eventually one day becoming extremely rich. Well, money in itself is ultimately a material thing like anything else. It's not inherently good or bad. Indeed, the use to which it's put, ultimately its value is determined by the mind of the person to whom it belongs.
The Gimson Teso Haya Bozo Gone, then he semi adjetan gore, Matobangazo, semi adjetan zevate, or Natsu Chulugre, then it is some Yangamare, Naranzo Mugula, Natsu Mug Chashis the semi indi, the adjetan get the Chulukutonda Mare, Naranzo Tonda, Mugutonda Res.
So understanding that this logic or understanding this way that things operate, we need to appreciate the value of developing and improving our minds. And not dismiss it as something that belongs to the realm of religion. Insofar as we all have a mind and it comprises a large part of our being, then its development is a matter for everyone and a matter for the individual person and not a matter intrinsically for religion.
So
as you know, very few people would say that training the body or keeping it fit is a religious matter. So too, training and keeping our minds fit is a matter for the individual, and it's something to which we need to really devote due attention.
Garting also got any simcum good in the Tante Latin, Dabo Yabo Magivna, then also so dragon and Lojon Yaposhit of Gomare, Shusoko told us one at any Lega Yabolet of Gomaris.
If we don't pay attention to the health of our minds, then we won't be able to do well in our studies, we won't be able to study well, we won't be able to work well, we won't come of good in many of the activities we engage in.
Then America got any Lodra Chimbo Kashig Nala, then the Loma Dini Yashavish Jirnati, then it don't sit gonna by you, don't sit gonna by Rindus.
Statistics say that in some American universities, as much as 45% of students have or suffer from depression.
Then it don't sit gonna by the Rindu with Jimson, Karizanatin, also Nunshin Damada, also. Lodra Chimbo Nala Yona, Pena Lodra Chimbo Nala Yondi, Mambos, the Quarantotini, Lodra Jambaganani, Antambo Shinitini, Lodra Dina Layonare, Dina Langasu Lodraganani, Antambo Tatanyan de Jerzantitini, Tama, Antambo Rindo Mari, Dina La Antambo Nibasamba Jebangabati Yondi, then he saw the same market by Shini, then he mumbles the Tindy Rindo.
And in some cases, this is due to the fact that there is a great deal of pressure and stress in universities for students who aspire to be the best among their peers. And when everybody is aspiring to be the best, not everybody can be. And so students feel a great deal of suffering due to their inability to compete. And due to this competition between people, we experience a great deal of suffering. Many people will think that, say, if among 10 people they are quite well off in terms of their study performance or in other areas of life, then they'll feel quite satisfied. But if they're somewhat below the standard of others, then they will feel agitated. And so this is the result of competitive feeling. Even in terms of Khenpo's own studies in the religious context in a monastery, there was also this kind of competition between students. In this context, there's a great deal of examinations, there's a great deal of tests, and in particular, a great deal of debate. And when people engage in the debating courtyard, there are often thousands of spectators looking on. So if a person who's engaging in debate doesn't do well, then they feel a great sense of discomfort.
Then it takes us to carry some goes in a same market persona, then penang around some mochi or not, tin on in half zanshu in a tit carchimbo marese, not so much on in half zanshu in the not dixu in the carchimbo marese. Then a car is in a not so much on any not zambu in nada, not dubu in nada, not on rangle, low soda, not on rangle, low junda, though.
However, at that time, a very beneficial thought was thinking that my studies and my performance is really an issue for me. My own improvement and my own progress is in fact a matter of my individual concern. Whether or not I'm among 10 people considered the best or not so good, it's really not a question of comparing myself to others. But a lot of people really don't put a lot of emphasis on the intrinsic value in their own individual education. They think their source of happiness or satisfaction comes from being the best among 10 students. And in fact, they're really, in thinking this way, and not really considering the benefit, for example, that they're going to put their achievements to, or the way that they're going to help others. Of course, we're not disavowing here the value of competition in some situations. It is in some amount necessary. However, if we think only about this, then our minds will become very ill. So for this reason, everybody in the university today, students really need to think very hard about the value of their life and what they want to do of meaning with this life. But if people think that their happiness is going to come from fame or from riches or from status or privilege, then this is a very outdated, obsolete way of thinking. And the fact that this kind of thinking is obsolete and outdated is something that many people in the 21st century realize. So, many people realizing this, what we really need to do is to build or to forge a new path or road to happiness and to benefiting others. So in looking to whether there is such a road or in looking to how we could forge this path, then or perhaps even asking the question of whether it exists, the answer is it certainly does, and the answer lies in developing and improving our own minds. But in respect of improving and developing our own minds, there are many people who in the present day still do not think mainly about how they're going to help others and be of benefit to others. Their thoughts, for the most part, revolve around themselves. So if we had a choice of very comfortable and luxurious transport methods, say boats and airplanes and cars, etc., then everybody would choose the means, or almost everybody would choose that means that was most comfortable for themselves. And in fact, everybody would head towards whichever method, means of transport that was. If, for example, flying in business class was something that didn't require a lot of money and there were no limitation on seats, then there would be very few people, it would seem, who would say be willing to give up their seat to other people. And the same selfish logic pertains also in terms of regions where we live. So those areas that are safe and those areas that are unsafe. Of course, we want to live in the area that's safe, and as for the unsafe areas, therefore other people.
Koyang kesalan de gozi, tani
But conflict inevitably ensues from this situation where every single individual is relentlessly pursuing their own ideal of happiness. And in order for ourselves to be victorious and to vanquish our opponents, we deploy a lot of the fruits of our knowledge and our skills, and we consume and waste a lot of resources.
And
countless numbers of weapons are used, and we create wars and conflicts, and a great deal of suffering results in the world.
And
the essence of all of this is our own basic selfishness.
And
of course, to think about one's own happiness or to wish for one's own happiness is not mistaken. However, if we really become very tightly attached to our own happiness, then what ultimately results is the unhappiness of others. So for this reason, at the level of our minds, we really need to train ourselves in the aspiration of benefiting others. In terms of we humans, there are many, many respects in which our thoughts and actions are grievously mistaken. So one of these would be the idea that in order for my own individual happiness and satisfaction, or that I do everything, I speak words, I do my work, I undertake everything I do for the sake of my own happiness.
And then
many people think that by doing things in undertaking all that we do for the sake of others, the result of that is only that others will receive happiness and enjoyment, not that we will ourselves. But this idea is really, really wrong. In actual fact, true happiness and genuine happiness comes from thinking about how to bring others happiness, doing everything that we do, undertaking actions and words, everything to bring them happiness. This is from where we will achieve real happiness. So many people think that really it's by having all the things that they need in their material lives, by being very rich, by having a fancy house, etc., that this will be the genesis of their own happiness.
Tani samlo te yang nora rindu zi, te la tani nguni tani nga tsu demo kipo yunga mandu zi, ta ta mamambo wa hako yo res.
But of course this is mistaken, and actually these days there are a great many people who really realize this.
Tani yindi nga tsu lopta chimo mambu zi te pe na Amerika lopta mambu ta wun zambalang la shikin yo res.
In the world today, American universities have great influence in other countries in the wider world.
Tani lopta chimbo tu so nani, tani mo tani rang ton tak tak la samlo tan ma to ba jan ton la samlo tan machine ken. Tani kwaran so tani la pa ha chang tani tamo rig pa thamo tani le kan ram le go na le shin ken. Yin na samlo ti rang do tak tak ma to ba jan la samlo tan machine ken tani mambo zhi ke chang shi jang na.
So given the influence and impact that American universities have on the wider world, if students at and academics at American universities are really only thinking about deploying their skills and knowledge to selfish ends, then this will have a very negative impact on the greater world.
Tani maung pa na nga tsu tani zambo lang de tani chi yargin ro mo ro ta yakbo zu yong mo yong tani tarta nga tsu lobda chim mo ti na ni chang zambo lang la shikin chim bo yong kong ka tani lobda chim bo na na yong kong ka lobma tiso la rak le gres maung pa de kan ri rindu.
Really, the future direction that our society, our world society at large will take really rests and relies on this current generation of university students in influential universities and what they decide to do.
Tini mo te tsu samlo ta kan tis rendro, tini korang zhyan la samlo tangken ka tini zhyanpen, tini ka samlo chan tis reta, yang na korang zhyan tangta la samlo tangken tini tis rendro, tu lopta ka loso la tengdo res.
And whether this generation of university students will decide to commit their lives to the benefit of others, or rather to their own selfish ends, hinges on the education in these universities.
Tendi yendi nga sam nge samlo tamba ya nga so lobda chimbo nam ga nangla deni mi semkam yarge so tong ya ga tapsi semkam yarge so tong ya ga deni lobjung ta lobchen lobchit tendi yo pa de hale ba gar chimbo res.
So for this reason I'm of the view that in universities today courses on the need to or the courses on improving the mind, developing the mind and training the mind are of utmost importance.
Tani mi samlo yargi thong ya ga tani thapshin du so thamshepo shir tambu gani yongwa rezi na nga tsu chulu gana na yongba rezi.
These methods that we can apply to training and improving the mind in originality are derived from religion.
Yena tambu yongna chulu gana na yongba reta yena tata nga tsu lopta chenpo mambu gana la tani chulu gzena yang tani chulu ngoma tani te yong choksa ma choksa namanda tsongdamda mambu nduzi.
However, in terms of the secular university context today, there are, you know, all kinds of prohibitions about the extent to which religion can be brought in.
Tani tata nga tsu tani ta chulu ta chupa shi ki ta tani lhota chimbo na chulu per ma chong na te kyo yo ma re ze. Nga tsu sem kam yargi su tong wi tab shi ta su tani korang chulu tar tu shi na chok bari ta yang na chulu tar ta ma shi ni Mashina chula tapa mashina chokore chula tapa menken namgiyo tabshi te nga cho peshu shina chokore.
But this really doesn't matter. The point is, for the sake of improving our minds, that what we need to do is whether or not it's linked with religion or not linked with religion, it's really the methods, the practices that we need.
Pena nyangji tawre ji nyangji da boyna teni tambu kani shonwari ji na teni chulu kanani teni shonwari ji. Yena tarta nga tsu tini te chulug la tapa yongkhin zik pesho tana chokore chulug la tapa menkhin zik pesho tana chokore sis ge pesho tana chokore ze.
A very good example of this would be compassion. Methods of training in compassion originally came from religious traditions, but these days they are being applied in university and school contexts everywhere, and they are equally applicable to people who are religious or people who are not religious. Compassion can be understood of in as being comprised of essentially two things.
Tonda tambo to kanre zena nyarje zewa te nga so zambalang to na tini moye na da chokchak yin na da tini dumri yo sa hale ba mambore ze korang so khashi zaji gonji me pa da deni kashi se deni na pa da deni kashi se sem go toni dungmer da dungmer jan ten di mambo re ze ko so go dungmer da nga so ha go je de liao jie ze ha go je de dong da dang bo re ze.
So the first part of compassion is the recognition, the understanding that humans and animals and in fact all kinds of living beings in the world experience suffering, whether that suffering be physical or whether it be mental in nature. In the world today, there are many examples of great injustice between humans, different humans, and between humans and other life forms.
Then, jamnyim mayim ba de yongwi gimsen de kani yongwi yores na ngatsu khosu de ni dungmer de mashi bi gimsen ji yongwi yores.
And in many cases, the reason for these sufferings, or the, sorry, the reason for these inequalities or injustices is because we don't appreciate or understand the suffering of others. So, for example, the failure of extremely affluent people to appreciate the suffering of those who are poor, the failure of people who have a lot of privilege in life to appreciate the experience of people who don't, this failure to appreciate the situation of others in less fortunate positions or in situations of suffering is a great problem.
Pena ngarang so napa main bi ne kemna nat me bi ne kemna lipo detang im bi ne kemna tin ngarang so nat napa so dungur da kandri zigen aso mambo ha ko maris.
So it's like, for example, when we're in a state of robust health, in a state of not being sick, it's very difficult for us to understand or appreciate the suffering of a person who is in a state of illness.
Tani nam ha ko rezena so rang la teni nat temni mangang na la longbi ne kamna teti tazo na pa dungur de kanre zin teni hako gres.
The point when we do finally come to an understanding of what their suffering is when this illness or physical suffering arrives on our own bodies, when we find ourselves in hospital or otherwise facing sickness or disease.
Teni tenji inan dukumandu zete ngaso kanre go ndu zena ngaso lipo detang yembe ne kamna nga chu nan mepi ne kamna tini mun na pa cho dungur to kan dizre sam nga chu samlo mambo tang go ndus.
But this isn't how it should be. It should be that while we're still in a state of health, while we're still in a good situation, that we apply ourselves to really trying to think and empathize about the situation of people who are in a state of suffering.
Tini mun na pa ti so dungur kan de nga so sem go thone samlo mambo tang ne tini samlo jimmo tang ne samlo tang za mo tang ne tini che yong di tini nga so tini ko so dungur ta hali pa ga saru z tini ha ko yong go res.
And it's really by thinking and applying our minds to in a very meticulous and profound way to empathizing and thinking about the suffering of others that we will be able to arrive at an understanding.
Then it did the murder sorrows of going in the cabinet in Ingat or Tati Dumerting a Roshigo, Sandy Samlo de Kiongres.
And when we do understand and appreciate this suffering, when this feeling arises in our hearts, then comes with it the desire to do something to help alleviate this suffering.
Then Roshigo, Sandy Mundu Kangongres in Langa, Pena Mosambas, the Dumerting Aranga, Semganala, Saru, Koyona. Tini ngi sem ganala ti motela tini dungur te mesona samne ngi tini sem ganala molum jab karezi ta dungur te mesona samne ngi sem ganala tini jewa tini jegeres.
And so what this entails is really through arriving at a really clear appreciation of the suffering of others, and on that basis really developing a prayer and a great aspiration and wish in one's mind to be able to do something so that they will not be in this state of suffering.
Deni rewa jabni tindi shipine kamna teni ngarang sem ganala otangi rewa jaba chi bo yong gum de ngi molum jaba chi bo yong gum de ngarang ga ngus rokshi go ndu samne teni ngasola sambate yong gres.
And then based on this, of course, it's not sufficient for us to simply pray or to hope for the alleviation or suffering of others. It's essential that on the basis of this hope and prayer that we undertake to engage in actual real action. And so, putting it succinctly, the recognition that another human or an animal or other form of living being is in suffering, and on that basis, the aspiration to undertake action to help them eliminate that suffering. These two together are what we call compassion.
Then it is some lote, Munetanesha, not the some lote, the Namba Sanje Bag, the Taba Chimbo, some lotes.
This compassion that we're speaking of is derived from the Mahayana Buddhist tradition.
Yenayan Kuranga Nyarjiti, the Nipeshitana, the Namba Sanje Bala Kurantaba Shina and Chokore, Kurantaba Mashina and Chokore.
However, these practices of arousing compassion, and indeed your own compassion, the use that you put it to, it doesn't matter if you are Buddhist or not. You can be, but you don't have to be. Really, whether one is a religious, is a Buddhist follower or Buddhist practitioner, someone who has faith in the Buddhist doctrine, this is really a question quite apart from the practice of compassion. So practices directed to engendering and increasing compassion are things that anyone, regardless of whether they're Christian, they're Buddhist, they're Muslim, they're atheist, can all apply. But the method, the way of bringing a person from a state of not having compassion to having compassion and then moving on to increase the quality of the compassion, these methods and practices are from the Mahayana Buddhist tradition. But when we're talking about the efficacy of these practices, it's not like supplicating a Buddhist deity or expecting some kind of intervention from an outside force. These are really practices that one puts into practice oneself, and through committing oneself to them diligently, obtains results on this basis. This compassion doesn't have any relation to an outside god or some kind of outside deity or other kind of force that is in some way conferring this compassion on us. It's literally generated through the practice of recognizing another's suffering and on this basis developing a heartfelt aspiration to eliminate or reduce that suffering.
Nyarji gomlug de tene namba ga na na shyo pi thapsi tim dordi zu shine samala ngotu jig yins.
And I just like to go on from here and give everybody a brief introduction to the actual practice of compassion in Buddhism.
Tene tambo kandi chig go re ze na ga so mugo tene mon mchobo mon napa tene mo tene dumre yo sa tene yen da ya na pe na ga so Tini Simpson Dunru Bena Shira Nana Yo Pitini Simpson Dawa Yananda Dindiga Dungur Hajang Chimbo Yo Baga Dindiga Moyena Dunru Yena the Dindizulanga to Mukata Gores.
So the practice that I'm going to talk to you about tonight is one where we with our own eyes, with our own naked eyes, we fixate on an object of great suffering, whether this be a person who is extremely poor, a person in a state of great destitution, or an animal, for example, who might be in a slaughterhouse and undergoing great suffering and pain.
Tini namgin nga cho pe na mo napa yin na cha, tini mo, tini chi dungar chenpo yo sa ga, tini mo yin na, chok chak yin na, tini tam thong wi kap si, tini nga cho chak zha wo re, chak ni, nga cho ta to wo yo ma re zi, ta po ke yo ma re ta,
In the ordinary course of our lives, we often find ourselves recoiling at the sight of things that are unpleasant or painful. But what we need to do in cultivating our compassion is really compel ourselves to face these things and look at them.
Or
at the same time, aside from, you know, really casting our eyes on scenes or sights of suffering, we also need to listen compassionately. So attune ourselves to, or really listen very intently and deeply to accounts or stories of suffering, whether they be from the historical past or whether they be things that we hear in the media, in the news, or things that other people tell us. Of course, it's quite common, it's almost routine in every day for us to hear stories about airplanes plunging into the ocean and people dying or millions of people perishing in an earthquake. However, for the most part, we tend to dismiss these stories as, or just register them in a very superficial way. Today, this many people died. Oh, yesterday, that many people died. And the reason that we dismiss them so easy is because we're really not thinking properly.
So
what we do need to do in terms of thinking properly is, say, upon hearing about an airplane that has fallen into the ocean, we need to think, what if among those 250 people, one of them was me?
Yana, ne ama, ne apa, or tenjis to tina la yoni tenite shisona kandian sari, chito, tina gomeni yada napchi, natina ne chito, naranga pada, naranga mayena, kandian sari, sami samotangores.
Or what if one of those people were my mother or my father?
Yana naranga puda, pumu de tini tina la tini, timuschi de te yena kandian sari, sami samotangores.
Or my daughter or my son?
Yeah. Yana nga cho tini pun mun napan rawota, yana pena shira nga na tundu mambo sake yore, o tundi tini simchin dumur mambo yosati, nga yana nga nda yana kanti yin sare, samning sam lo tango res.
Or in terms of an extremely ill person or animals that are facing slaughter, similarly, we need to really think very deeply, what if I were one of them?
야 연합 시라고 나라 요딘디 심진들이 만보사께 요마 네 아마도 있나 나른 거 뿌도 있나 네 보모도 있나 그런 거 먹지라야 노바께요 말에 먹지라야 노바께요 말에 옛나양 띠니 만남 거 띠니 그런 종네 띠니 따르단디나 띠니 나니 지치메나 띠니 그런 띠니 너나 띠니 사께요나 다 건디엔사레 삼네 띠니 당접고그레스
So, or in terms of animals facing death at the in this situation, what if one of them were my mother or my father, who for the entire duration of their life has really done nothing to hurt another person, and yet despite this, this is essentially the treatment that they are receiving. What if that were the case, that it were me or my mother or my father?
Then there was a kind of some example of the whole thing. This type of gender, the new magic mambo yoni, the mambo shundo ze karti. Ti macam kan ala sendong kan ke muda, ngarang ini nak kan diri, ngarang ke cimla, dini ngarang ke payah lah dini macam tin disusun ini, ngarang ti cawla dini makasih sana kan diri insari sana samlotan gugundus.
Or in terms of the you know many wars that are waged in the world every day, what if one of the person who was to die in these wars was me, or a war in my hometown? What if it were me, or my mother, or my father, or one of my family members?
Tini yang acun zamalang ke sasha kasihlan, tini mugi mampu yang sama la zaki me kunci me yang na naim ramadhan yang ni tini dengar mampu yang kedua, tini ti nala ngarang ti nala yang na ngai kanti cegu sari sam, yang na ngai kimsang tu ti nala yang na ngai boda bomoda apa amat so ti nala yang na kanti yang sari sam ni tis samlo tanggus.
And in people who experience great hunger and destitution and suffering in everyday society similarly, what if it were me or one of my family members?
Tini samlo tang zapo tini tang har hale pa tang zapo tini tang yon di tini ngaso sim ko tola changa ki yon gores.
And by really thinking about this in a very deep and profound way, then we generate a feeling of fear.
Tini tik.
And this fear, which is a recognition of others' suffering, is the first stage of compassion meditation.
Ngai na ngarang dewa yona gawa jinta tini korang yang dewa yona gagare ngasun janda reze ngai terang tini sak mandug tini cum mandug namjun hongjong kengen mati nala ngai mandug ta yena yang tini ngasun janda reze samne tini samlotang gore te kumpani pade reze.
And the second stage of this contemplative meditation is moving on from our recognition of another's suffering, the awareness that we are not that person, that today we are not in a state of great hunger or distress or facing the threat of being killed. And in really registering this awareness, we need to also keep in mind the basic equality of all people, the fact that just as I wouldn't want any of these things to happen, neither does the people who are in this situation want this to be happening to them.
Tini ngarang tu zamalang katini macam mana, macam mon mon nam katini, dongko papa karu yore, nakpo yore, seru yore, papa jaga maris. Tini jawab sekarang ngarang tu mon mampu lod meruk soso lodjin jaga maris, meruk soso jabjong jaga maris, syarat buku ringni jaga maris. Ina tontaga ni tolong ngarang tu caman jaga maris.
So in the world today, there is great diversity in terms of people's skin colors and cultures and histories and contexts and backgrounds, but there are two basic respects in which we're all the same.
Niti kangrezina, pena ngarang, tini dewa yona, sam nga demo chepo yong sona, samne dewa chimbo yona ta ngarang le gada, dewa chung 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 tini yena ngarang yona gaga yore, tini nga chung zambalanga ma tsangma chikpares.
The first of these respects is the in which we are similar is essentially our desire for happiness, whether that be a great happiness or just a little happiness in general. The desire to be happy is something that humans everywhere share.
Tani nipa te kang rezina pena ngarang la tani dungur mayona gagayore dungur chembo mayona ta lega dungur chong su tani mayona gagayore aso li. Papa itu kalau tini cerma cung-cung zindu anjau, tini juga pernah ngaco kap jebine kemna, titi-titi cung-cung macam sahur malah ta, papa kap ke papa phupi tini to dungwar ta chong chong ma to yo mar ta nga so te la ma chak ne te ang me na nga so ga yo re nga rang tini nga rang so ga ba jin te tini mu chama de dang ja wa re chama so so la dungwar me na sam kan zo ma to chi gyang yo ma re ti thone nga so ram nim re
And the second respect in which we're all basically the same is the wish not to experience suffering, even the smallest amount of suffering, suffering that comes from a pinprick or a thorn, feeling a thorn pierce our skin. From the smallest kind of suffering up to very great forms of suffering, we all have a basic desire not to suffer. So everybody, despite their wish not to suffer, unfortunately has to deal with the fact that they will suffer. And by the same token, even though we wish for happiness, we're not necessarily able to obtain it. So we really need to think about the fact that just as I experience suffering from not being able to obtain happiness, so does essentially everyone else. By really developing a really strong sense of the basic equality or equalness in our experience, then we will not be able, or we won't engage in behavior for our own interests that causes suffering for others.
Then in Namjin, I want to pay now. She may be near Kabzilla, then it's Sapahajan, she may be near Kabzilla, not so cheshire them count on you now.
Quite often, say on an extremely hot day when everybody is feeling parched and there's one bottle of water to drink, we will be thinking about quenching our own thirst and won't be necessarily paying much attention to how others are feeling thirsty like ourselves. And the reason that in this situation we would be thinking about ourselves and not about others is this habituated tendency to be thinking in this way about ourselves and not casting our minds to others.
Yeah, garti ti ne kamna nga sung ne jan lan dang jab ne ong nga ang kom gundu dungur yong gundu ta jan la yang dungur yore samji ti samlo ta ta na otni ta nge chikshir tum ka gana ne kham bo gang thong jire te win thong mare jan ba ta jan la nge jing gres.
If I were used to or practiced in thinking about others aside from myself, then in such a situation, I wouldn't take more than one mouthful. I would offer the rest to others. In the future, the world's resources are becoming increasingly diminished.
And
if the people in today's universities are becoming or are extremely selfish in their interests, then this is how the rest of the world will become.
And
if this is how things will proceed, then in the future, the scarcity of resources will become something that people are engaged in great conflict
over.
So just saying or throwing around slogans like world peace, this in itself won't do it.
Then you do your leka the young rambo ni kale 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 lenin rogo is.
In fact, the gradual step-by-step work towards world peace is something we need to engage in. And this work towards world peace is not something that we should just do with our words, but something we really need to do in terms of our working on our minds.
And
in terms of this work on our minds, part of it is obviously working on ourselves, but the greater part is really working on thinking about others. And if we're really able to do this, then it will yield benefits in terms of future conflicts over world resources. If we are Buddhists, for example, beyond the kind of meditative contemplation technique I've introduced tonight, there are, of course, lots of levels and stages beyond this. But if a person is not Buddhist, for example, then just sticking with the basic practice of compassion is itself
enough.
Okay, so now we're going to move on to the third stage of the compassion meditation or contemplative practice. After we have first recognized the suffering of others, and secondly established a view of equality, where we see that this suffering, desire to avoid suffering and to obtain happiness, is something that everybody shares, and that on this basis it is not okay for me to do something for my own happiness or selfish interest that is at the expense of another's happiness. So at this point, we generate an extremely powerful aspiration to do things, to undertake action to eliminate or reduce the suffering of others. And this third stage is the final stage of the
practice.
And after we've completed the third stage of this meditation, or achieved some kind of stability in this practice, then it's time for us to turn to actual action in society, whether that be benefiting each other, others through our words, or being, or benefiting others through the actual deeds that we do. So in terms of family life, if members of a family are able to practice in this way, thinking about the situation of each other, then it will bring great happiness at the family level.
And
then at a level of, say, a town or a city, if its inhabitants are able to habitually think about this way and contemplate each other in these ways, then it'll bring happiness and peace to that particular place. And then as we scale up, if this kind of practice can be undertaken by people in the world at large, then this is when we will arrive at happiness for everyone and world peace. So the contemplation practice on compassion that Khenpo has introduced tonight is just a very abbreviated, simple, straightforward approach that everybody can apply. In the Buddhist tradition, there are, of course, many practices on contemplation, some of them very detailed, that go into many, many stages and levels. And if people are interested in learning about them, then they should consult one of the many resources that exist on these teachings.
Tso tamche po tini sozo karde rang samlo rang tini mubayo na tini rang lojong shena chokre ne terang chapati chik nyangji chik po de yens.
So the compassion practice that I mentioned tonight is one way that the Tibetan tradition views the development or progress of the mind. The practice that was introduced tonight is one but of many, and if you have the interest or desire, it's something that you can put into practice yourselves.
Tini yargi khsim yopinani nipati kanrezena tini mog kunshu ke yargi teris mog shopa ge yargi teris.
So the first type of progress that the traditional traditional Tibetan worldview, being the development of one's mind or the progress of one's mind. The second being the development or progress of one's moral behavior and conduct. And then the third type of progress would be material or economic development or progress.
Then yargi khsim ti nani kar chi shu de kan rezena sem ge yargi sem kam ge yargi tela ngunzen gres.
And of these three different types of progress and development, the most important is the first one, the development of one's mind.
Then derang ga chu yargi ge tini kor shu su go de shu su yargi ge nala namba ge tini nipa gari thongre zi ki tin chat chat tani
So this brings to conclusion my talk tonight about the influence of Buddhist ideas of social progress, and we've got another half hour or so remaining, and I'd welcome any questions you might have. And thank you everyone for listening.